sight and guess it's all
Print is out of ink.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Lame.
Why'd you make your own? Like an octopus or something. Whatever.
We already squinched out from.
His fingertips?
What, spaghetti fingers?
Why don't you lick these fingertips, boy?
Lick these fingertips.
Don't threaten me with a good time.
So I'm Goose Pumps.
Goose
like
Goose
sounds
Pumps.
Similar.
Goose Pumps.
Sounds
okay.
Similar.
Like Goose Bumps.
Yeah.
But Goose Pumps.
By R.F. Schmein.
Yes.
R.L. Schmein, yeah.
They're either Goose Shoes or something else.
Right.
I don't
know.
Yeah. You got like the old pump sneakers that
yeah,
used
like
the puff up. At basketball scene, but instead it's just
high.
A big goose on your feet.
Every time you do there's a bomb.
That's not the sound that we make.
I don't know. Geese sound? That's how they sound, right?
They say
geese?
bread.
Apparently
no,
they
like
are assholes who attack people.
Yeah, geese are ducks.
Okay, when I went away to college, that we had like little ponds all over the campus. Geese everywhere.
Mm-hmm.
But for some reason, every time I walked past them, people walked past them all day. I would walk past them, I'd get them following me and like squawking at me.
It's because you're a soul of ginger.
And try to bite me.
Right.
And then I'd have to run, and then I'd turn back and watch my friends just walk right past them. Every time.
They have souls. That's why.
I hate them.
They have souls.
That's why I don't get attacked.
I would just start chopping geese down. Left and right. Like, if a geese comes at me,
I wonder
whack.
How
I can take a goose.
You ever seen a Christmas toy, motherfuckers? You're about to be dinner!
How easily can its neck break?
I don't know.
Think about
Mythbusters. Get on
how
it.
How easily can you snap a goose's neck?
Yeah, if I close on
it's just,
take
it's
the
just
answer.
Too fucking easy.
Who is it? Adam?
Adam and Jamie.
Adam and Jamie. You just see Jamie, like, with a goose. You just, whack, and he just whips it, and he's like, pretty fucking
that's
easily.
That's scientific term. All right, fine. 32 PSIs. Like.
Yeah, like a quick twisting motion with the wrists, and these things are done squawking at you. Fuckies.
Can you
good
buy
to know.
A goose in, like a butcher shop?
A gold
yes.
one?
Oh, yeah.
Not in a live one, but you can buy, like, goose,
a
like,
dead,
goose
dead
meat.
One.
Yeah.
So you can probably capture a live one.
Or you could try there.
Just put some bread in a cage.
That wouldn't work.
Done deal.
Done.
I mean, I show up.
Geese,
I like
goose trap.
Oh.
Goose hunting by goose pumps.
Right.
Or
that's
what if you tased it? Like you got a taser?
Why?
Like one of those that shoot out?
Imagine if it just made it angry.
Oh my god. Well, I'd have a baseball bat.
Geese are actually really hard to kill. And then they're like...
They're crafty.
Yeah.
I kind of want to... I mean, I don't. Yeah,
I
don't
want to try.
Someone, there was a video on YouTube of a guy, and he was like swatting away a goose with his briefcase, and the goose was attacking him. So what someone did was they basically like photoshopped the entire scene to be a goose versus a guy in a lightsaber fight.
Oh, that's awesome.
It was pretty well done and pretty hilarious.
That's awesome. Who are you people, by the way?
I'm Matt, you know. At all of YouTube.
I'm Matt, and I'm grouchy.
We're going to see a scary movie, goddammit.
Yeah,
Matt's nervous. We're going to see...
As Above, So Below.
That.
That's the one.
It looks pretty fucking creepy.
Yeah.
But I usually am okay with movies where it's like, you have to be someplace for something terrible to happen to you. Because I just won't go to that place.
Yeah, like the things that take place in your home. Like, we watched Dark Skies before we came here. So it was like, that's in your own home. Invaders, some sort of invader coming into your home. So
invaders
that.
Him is what it was.
Exactly. Like. But for this one, As Above, So Below, is in the French catacombs where something creepy is happening.
I'm not
so
French.
We're not going to the French catacombs. So
that's
why
I think I'll
be
alright.
Yeah.
I don't know, I've always considered myself a... Parisian at heart.
Parisian?
That joke is exclusive for anybody who's met me.
Very seldomly do I go to a cabin in the woods, and it's usually one that I know is pretty alright.
And well populated.
Yeah, well populated.
Yep.
I don't like going to cabins. I like I'm down at the cabin if I can go, oh, hey, what's going on, to the neighbors.
Yeah.
Like, if something bad were to happen, you'd be like, Steve!
Yo, Mike! Mike! Shit is happening!
I fell!
Run down!
Have you seen a guy with a knife? I mean, he called me!
Ah! Oh, he got me!
Oh,
I regret stopping to run and talk to you.
How's the life?
Man.
You are? I'm sorry.
I'm Reggie. Reggie Taters. At Reggie Taters. Those are words I mixed up. Who are you?
I'm Nikolai. You reach me at Nikolai Arla.
Saichi boy. That's such Arla.
And you can send emails to
RLF at alchestbreach.com.
What was RLF that? At... Oh. Chessbreach.com.
What?
Who?
Sarge?
Oh, RLF. Is it at lchessbreach.com?
Goosepumps.com.
At Goosepumps.
All of us.
RLF at lchessbreach.com.
That was good.
That was good.
Surprise.
It's like a harmony.
Or at Dope Cell.
Yeah, or at Dope Cell.
Oh, we'll get them. First
thing
that you should do.
Dope
Cell tweets.
Right.
Oh, so let's kick it off.
Well, kick what off exactly?
The day.
Well, I think Tommy Gunn will tell us with his beautiful YouTube comments intro song.
The videos on YouTube have a place called the comment section where people can type out heartfelt and thoughtful reflections of the videos they just watched. Like you at RLF on Wednesdays, now the gang will read a few. It's really hard to rhyme the word Wednesdays.
Ooh, doggy. That was beautiful.
I'm aroused.
Oh, Tommy Gunn, every time.
I heard it.
Shut up!
Just there.
Yeah, what did it sound like?
What did it sound like?
Magic.
No, I mean, yeah.
Who we haven't addressed yet?
What?
What episode this is?
Oh,
you haven't even said it. Well, if you can't count,
because
we've done 94 of these before. 1995.
You know what I want to try? You know how you do the, now if you want to edit this out, because it comes out totally horrible.
Okay.
I want to do the, you know how you do what the fuck? The Life is But a Dream. Merrily. Life is But a Dream. What song is
row,
that?
Row.
Yeah.
You do that at different points. I want to do that with 1995.
But how do we do that?
So you go 19, and then right when you start saying 95, you say 19.
Okay.
And then when he starts to say 95, you say 19. And then when he starts
so
to say...
So let's try it out right now.
1995. Oh, yeah. Really? Because as soon as he started, I was like,
I'm dizzy now.
I'm dizzy. That was uncomfortable.
We could all do it like at once.
Well, I was going to say, let's do that way one more time. And then, once I say it at the end, we all say it together in unison.
This is a really tough thing.
No, I don't think multiple times throughout the show.
We got this.
I don't think we do.
We have this.
Please.
All right.
Ready?
I'm just going to start.
Wait, what are we doing?
We're going to do what we just did.
And then all
after
together?
That,
oh, man, all right.
I'm going to count us down, and we're going to say 1995 again, and once more time, in unison.
One more time.
Ready?
No.
1995.
I feel really
dirty.
Awful.
I'm not doing that multiple times throughout
the show.
What are you doing? I know, I'm doing that. That's way too much.
Did I say let's do that multiple times throughout the show?
Yeah, you were like,
oh, God. I'm gonna throw up.
Oh, no way.
I'm gonna throw up.
Thank you. If this is someone's first episode, like, why?
They just said numbers.
They're saying things. I didn't even listen to. This is 95.
It's episode 95. They're talking about the year 1995. It doesn't make any sense.
Fucking nerds.
I hate you.
Nerds.
I hate you all.
John, they can't hear you.
No.
It's a computer.
They know.
No, John.
They know.
All right. Okay, John.
He's falling down the hole.
Oh,
he's going down the hole again. He always when he's scared.
Well.
All right, now that we've gotten that done.
Let's talk about the comments.
Comments.
94.
Our first comment comes from a Casual Slenderman.
Oh.
Whoa. He's casual. Whoa, that's so casual, man.
Well, let's hope it's not all man for Slenderman. Al, will you father my baby T-Rexes?
Oh, that'd be cute. How would you raise them? What would you call them?
I mean,
how many would you have?
You made a pretty decent video of yourself being a T-Rex.
Being a T-Rex?
Didn't you make one of you being a T-Rex in your backyard? Oh, no, you were a chicken.
When was I a chicken?
How do you make a T-Rex and a chicken?
I swear to God, this is an actual video.
You know what? I do that more often than you'd think. No, what?
Yes.
Oh, man, this tastes just like T-Rex. I mean, chicken. Shit. Fuck.
No. You were doing something, or was it a velociraptor?
Was it for some... I think it was a velociraptor.
You were, okay, yeah, that's what it was. You were a velociraptor, not a T-Rex. My apologies.
Still.
I remember you being a dinosaur in your backyard.
Sorry about the dinosaur.
I don't really remember, but...
Yeah, I don't know.
Yes, I will. And I'm going to feed them geese, because then I'll have an excuce to hit geese.
Yeah!
Because, as we established earlier, fuck geese.
Fuck geese.
Goose pumps. Fuck geese. I'm feeding them to dinosaurs.
I like your pillows. No, I like your squawking. I like the way you fly.
I like how you're trying to eat my feet.
You mean to Reggie? No.
Yeah. No. Well, that's fine.
Come on. I haven't tried to kill you in weeks.
Weeks.
Yeah, but,
weeks.
But you've tried.
That being said, Haunted Lord.
Yeah,
hey, Alan, friends. You too, Sage. Nice. I just wanted to say that I've watched your vids. I'm sorry. I'm the worst at this shit. I just wanted to say that I've watched your vids for a year and a half now, and I love all of you, not gay.
Oh, we love you too, not gay.
Oh, not
love
gay.
Your vids make me laugh all the time, and you're all amazing, even Sage.
Man.
I added that part. Please read this next week.
Oh,
well, there you go.
Dream come true.
Oh, and then finally, Jacob Dickert. Yep. Mm-hmm. Like us to know, cold spaghetti is fucking delicious. Fuck you guys.
I'm going to call bullshit on that.
Yeah, nope.
Cold, cold spaghetti.
Get out of my house, cold
so we
spaghetti.
A little bit of ass kissing, and then we got sent right back down to reality.
That's right. Someone was real. It's like, real talk, though? Real talk. Throw it in a refrigerator for 10 minutes. I'll eat that shit up.
Wait, 10 minutes?
I mean, an already
oh, okay.
lukewarm plate is, you know, yeah. Throw it in it.
Come on, Al.
I'm basing nice everything off
do you know how
of
physics work?
Geese.
Why are there not reverse microwaves yet?
Because...
The reverse microwaves!
Someone explained it once.
Razor?
Just once. Not like a fast ball sack.
Yeah. So, like...
Is that what it is?
Yeah.
Because it's easier to add heat than it is to remove it.
And I think not that many people need it.
I would need it.
For what?
to cool things
for
down.
What?
You ever been halfway through a bowl of ice cream? Answered.
I like one scoop. I'm like, I'm good.
You
I got,
know,
my,
two
I got
cookies.
My two cookies.
Yeah,
and I haven't even bitten.
You have a standard three.
I kind of have to poop, so I might not even eat them.
That might be overfilling you.
Yeah.
Two Chips Ahoy cookies. I'm going to poop this week. I can't eat anymore.
I might die.
Oh, my God.
You expect me to pop?
Well, thanks for our YouTube comments, everyone.
Thank you.
You just learned a lot about Al's digestive system.
So we got some Tweety Beats.
Let's
oh,
tweet
we
beats.
Do have
tweet
some Tweety
Beats.
Tweet
beats. Hey, tweeters.
I like that, Tweety Beats.
All right. So.
Get on it, Tommy Gunn. JK.
Call Twitter Beats.
At NAHLES24.
What's up, numbers?
Yeah.
Nick Alice.
Made letters.
Nicholas.
What's up, Nick?
Yeah. Nicholas. And all of YouTube. If you could erase one invention from the past, what would it be and why?
I guess the cotton gin?
Cotton gin?
Why would that be what you take away?
You want slavery?
Because that's what made slavery explode as much as it did.
Oh, right.
I think they would have just had slaves.
I mean,
regardless.
They still had slaves, but then they had slaves. Then they started breeding people to have more slaves.
Well, yeah.
Because they had cotton gins and they needed more cotton picks.
Yeah, but I think any, like, invention at that, like, Any sort of economic step forward that required more production would have validated the fact that they wanted more slaves. Because if you have 3 guys to do the work for you, why not have 20?
I hear what you're saying, but it all sounds racist. No, I'm very pro-slavery stance right
now. No, it's not.
Yeah, why are you so racist?
No, it's not. It was a horrible time, and it should never happen again.
Well,
but what I'm saying is, that was the mindset of people who were there. Not going to address that. Not going to address that one. Okay.
No, man.
No, like everyone is slaves.
You're deflecting.
Like robots.
You're deflecting.
And geese.
You and the geese.
And pink people.
All right, so
they're never people. Slaves. Let's hear that one. We're serfs at the very lowest.
Pink people?
Yeah.
No, like actual pink people.
Oh,
yeah.
Like Porky Pig?
Like people from Venus.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know, people from Venus.
Yes, they're aristocrats.
Ooh.
I would say the gun.
I was going to say the gun, too. I was going to say artillery, and because it led to, you know, like, the nuclear power. So it would be strictly, like, swords.
How are you going
to
get
straight
sure.
up? That's
I want
what I want.
Straight up
keep
swords.
Trying to take my guns, Obama.
I'm gonna say cars. Get rid of cars.
What? God. Really?
Yep.
No.
Yep. If I'm doing it, I'm going
real,
big.
He's a real locomotive type man.
Trains and horses, just like the old West.
Zeppelins. Ooh.
No cars. We need Zeppelins.
I'll take chemical weapons. Can we do that one?
That's like the most realistic one that wouldn't have a.
Well, that's what I meant. What I meant by saying guns, like any sort of guns, but I feel like wouldn't lead to
creation
of like atomic or.
Then we'll go straight to
people
lasers.
Would still have bows and arrows. That would be cool.
Yeah.
Robin Hood.
I want bows and arrows.
Bows and arrows.
That's what real men are.
Yeah.
Not some guy who can fucking press a button on a helicopter and watch 20 people explode.
Yeah.
But, like, just one guy who's like, I have a sword. Come at me.
Yeah, it's one-on-one. Much cooler.
True that.
Mm-hmm. I was gonna say money, but then I realized that's not really an invention.
Yeah, you hippie.
Yeah, it is.
It's absolutely an invention.
You nerd.
Absolutely.
I think it's one of the objects.
No, it's a concept, actually. More...
Yeah, money is absolutely just like it's a concept.
I'll trade you geese for
trade
that
you
iPhone.
Geese for
no,
your,
but like
for
I'm
money.
Totally cool with the concept of like I do stuff for you, you do stuff for me. We all
money,
get along.
Money,
communism.
Our barter system is the best.
Money, the way it is now, is one of the like the most influential concepts that mankind like has stumbled across in its like evolution.
Yeah.
Because it's one of the things that allows like you don't need to have a barter system.
Yeah, dude.
Remember when I had all the money?
Yeah.
Did everyone give an answer?
Yeah, let's go to the next one.
Yeah, yeah,
before
so Dickon
gets real serious
on
this.
I was trying to
take a look back at the...
Have some water.
Well, actually.
This one is from Gumber Frumpkins.
Yo, Gumber Frumpkins. Gumber
Frumpkins. At Cade the Viking. He asks...
Ooh, Vikings.
At RLF YouTube, if you could invent one holiday each, what would it be and how would it be celebrated?
Tater Day.
St. Patrick's Day 2.
Right?
Is it the day after St. Patrick's
no,
Day?
No, it's the day after that.
So you get one day to
recover.
Another
day of
partying. Nice, I like it.
No, you see...
Part 2. The redo.
No, you gotta have... Because Halloween, you got... Drinking.
Okay.
In the fall.
Yep.
4th of July, drinking in the summer.
Yep.
St. Patrick's Day is in the spring. Need to have a winter one because I mean, New Year's.
Yeah.
New Year's.
Does that?
A lot of people drink at Thanksgiving.
Thanksgiving. Yeah. Oh yeah. Oh yeah.
The
New
night
Year's,
before
that's
Thanksgiving
that's,
is considered the.
Yeah.
That's,
and
that's,
New
that's
Year's.
Fall. I can count that fall. Still.
Yeah.
Okay.
It is technically fall. So
say
that's
like
correct
like
to do
January.
So.
It's cold.
Like
23rd. It's fall by a month.
January 14th. Call it Tater's Day.
I don't know, do like the third Friday in January.
You're so weird.
Third Friday in January.
It's
drinking
day.
It's drinking day.
Third Friday in January. It's just called
drinking
day.
Drinking day.
Everyone gets off for it, too,
yeah,
so it's
everybody, what are you doing 20 days?
Drinking day.
Oh, it's drinking day.
If I could
have that old tradition of where we roll barrels down the street and they're painted different colors and we bet on which one will get to the bottom of the hill first, and then you're going to buy the first round. Drinking day traditions!
Drinking day! It'd be great.
Mine would be called Grumpus Day.
Ooh. Grumpus?
Grumpus Day.
Is that like...
And it falls on the same day every year, which is Black Friday.
Oh.
And every major retailer has to close down. Government enforced.
That's amazing.
I love that.
And it's just, and everybody who works in retail just...
Gets
know,
money.
Gets a raise.
Just gets... No, they get like people who are running like Grumpus Day sales show that you work in retail. 50% off liquor.
Love it.
There you go. Grumpus Day. Because fuck show Black Friday shoppers.
Show that Walmart name badge off. 50% off at the liquor store.
That's right.
My Tater's Day would include nothing but
just
all forms of potatoes. No.
I think you say like swords.
Spuds for everyone!
Make it rain for French fries.
Spuds and swords, guys.
I'm going to tell you mine after I go poop. So you can talk about some songs. Sorry for...
No,
it's okay.
This
cool.
is
That's
what
cool.
we wanted.
That's cool, Al.
This is
Alberto.
What we wanted.
I'm not cutting any of it out either.
Quickly, let's plan how we're going to kill Al.
Okay. All right.
I like that we have to whisper.
When he comes back in.
Yeah.
All right.
I'm closest to him, so I think I should wait till he gets past me to get him from behind.
Right, grab him around the waist.
He's so he wants to grab him from behind.
Yeah,
guys,
sexually
in
the
I
butt.
I have a samurai sword behind the bed. Mm-hmm. I can rip that out
how
right through
how
the
has
face.
Has he not found that yet,
dude? It's been years.
But he could.
I don't know.
But he could try and like move away from it. He's squirmy. He's quick.
He is.
So,
he is.
I think Saichi's got to hold him, and then you run like both of
straight.
Them.
Wait, I don't want that happening.
But you have to take this
one
for
the team.
Team.
Take
no,
one for the team.
But,
you gotta
hey,
get rid of him.
What?
But no.
Dude, we can back
try
you
and
up,
position,
I'm sure.
Try and position like your shoulder.
Or I push him away from me.
Right, no.
right towards the sword.
But what other suggestion do you have besides what they're saying?
Right.
To not get fucking stabbed. That's a good one.
I don't see that one.
Yeah. No, but we could think of a way that could happen.
Okay.
All right, explain it.
Go ahead.
Just try.
I got
I'll give you
nothing.
A second.
I got nothing.
Okay.
Yet.
Okay. So I will grab him, and then as you come at me with a sword, I will, push him away, and then you'll hit just him.
So
no, just him.
But what if she accidentally hits you?
No. What if I go over his shoulder? You know he's the height of a World War II.
Why would you go over his shoulder?
You need to hold.
Yeah, what if he moves?
I'm not Goku in this Raditz for the special beam cannon, alright?
you could get your snake way
I really
on.
I feel that you guys are not addressing how selfish Saichi is being right now.
What are the two of you going to do?
Hold on. Wait, look over there. Look over there, Saichi. Look over
Saichi,
there.
Saichi, look over
there. Let's plan out. We're going to kill Saichi.
I turned back around immediately and heard you.
What's happening?
All right, let's get back on track.
Okay. What are the two of you doing?
So if we're going to, well, I'm going to be there, obviously, for moral support.
Yeah. He needs to be there.
Why can't I be the moral support guy?
Matt needs to help me. He needs to encourage me.
I'll distract him with, like, my funny sayings. You guys know my, like, I'll just bust out one of my classic
hilarious. Yeah, so I don't have to hold him, because he'll be,
hey, everybody, it's Bear Matt. Right.
I don't need to hold him, because he'll be laughing.
I need somebody for moral support, then.
How about, this is better. Me and Matt each both grab an arm.
But then I might get cut.
No,
but then you hit him.
We can't risk that.
Oh, I don't want to get stabbed.
You're good.
He's going to have it. All right.
Can you think of 100%?
Like that one I just said
would
work.
Full plan.
Like that would have been perfect.
Hey, Al's back from booping. Hey, Al.
I'm Bear Matt. Rawr.
Get him!
So that was good. Twitter questions?
Yeah.
Some good'uns.
Yes.
Are we all done?
No. Al still has to tell us his holiday.
I guess. I don't know, it'd just be like an animal day, I guess. Where
it'd be a cat day, bro.
No, it'd be an animal day. Okay. Then it's gotta include everybody.
Yeah, because
get some dogs out. Plus, cats aren't gonna go out.
Plus, cats suck.
Cats will get attacked.
Yeah. Cats are kind of dicks to each other.
Yeah, they're not. Bring your dogs out. We'll have. Or actually, that was the first one. Just a block party day where everyone has a block party.
That was so much fun. If everybody was out.
I like that one.
Everybody has
a block party. Oh, so you saying that a party in the USA?
Yeah.
Yes. Ooh, that'd be good. I can't buy without the song.
That's the song for the day.
Do it, Miley.
Take your shirt off.
She'd be like, really now? After I've like just been posing naked for like a year and a half. Are you guys like that song?
Yeah.
Good party.
Oh, man.
So, thank you, everyone.
Thank you, everybody, for your Twitter questions.
So, are we going to know what the 1995 Switch prize is? Is that going to happen?
Funny, it was just nothing.
Yeah, I'm like, what the
gotcha, fuckers.
As I put out in my tweet, these two don't know, and me and Sage forgot, so.
Also.
Is it the fan art?
It's the fan art.
Nice.
We only got three submissions, so I did include some regular fan art.
Okay.
So it's three regs, and then three,
special.
Are we going through the regs first?
Yeah,
and
go
then
through those regs.
All right. Go through those regs?
All right.
Everyone
first
who did not feel like participating.
First one's from Rich G.
Rich G.
Rich
G.
Rich G.
Rich G.
Rich G.
Rich G. Boom.
What does it say?
I am Dick G.
Real life friends. Hey, blank. Hey, blank. And Seich brought, why are you stripping? Seich.
What?
And this is crocodile.
That was when
what is it? The day that Sight is tired of being called gay. So I guess you go in and that's what you scream during sex. So
crocodile.
Is that the thing that they forgot?
Yeah. No, that's the thing.
No. These are the regular fan
arts.
Oh, my apologies.
You
should
have. Lo siento. Just
very cool. Thanks, dude.
Thanks.
Thank you, Rich G.
Next one is from Little Bro.
Little Bro.
This is called, I think, it says Al Murder with Jim.
Oh, wow.
Boom.
Descriptive. Wow.
Oh, no, it's Dead Man.
Bear Man's dead.
Bear Man has no head.
Go forth, Night Stallion, Iron Thing of Night. And then, what's he saying down there, Saichi?
I was just using my bike. Chill out.
I'm still okay. I look pretty pissed.
You look seriously
you
pissed.
Are you drinking a beer out of a silly straw?
You are, yeah.
Yeah.
Well, it's taped around his head.
Yeah. So he's still alive. They're just taking him for the...
You taped the beer between your wizard hat and your ear.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Gotta keep the wizard hat on.
Gotta keep the wizard hat on.
Oh, I like that it's that stable. Mm-hmm. But you can tape things around it.
Well, it's a wizard hat. It stays in place.
Oh, yeah. Don't you know anything about wizard hats? Duh.
You're right. I'm being dumb.
Wait, so are you committing murder with Little Bro, or is that supposed to be Captain Apathy? That's what I went with.
I think that's Captain Apathy.
Okay.
Is it Jim?
Yeah. I don't know Little Bro's real name.
That's his real name, Little.
Mr. Bro. Mr. Bro.
Mr. Bro is my father. You can call
Mr.
me Little.
Mr. Bro,
time
call,
for me
call me Little.
This is pretty cool, though.
When he turns into an adult, his name's Big.
Big Bro.
Love it. Thanks, Little Broski.
Next one is from, I just wrote Elliot. I'm going to say it's Elliot Borge.
You think it's Rother
Rock? Elliot Borge. Is it Elliot Borge?
I think it's Elliot Borge.
Who knows?
Let's see.
The last picture was from Elliot W.
That's right.
So, boom.
Oh
man.
Elliot Borge did not make this.
Oh.
He posted that up in the top right.
Oh, wow.
So this is not Elliot Borge.
I just heard the same, I'm sorry.
The pool is the only thing that's wet.
I like your chest hair in this.
It is
it's
very,
like,
the smile.
I like the fact that your tattoo just says bitch.
Look at the Amish beard.
Yeah. Oh, God. Look at
and the hair lip.
It's perfect.
Oh, God, the hair lip.
I'm Paw
Fish. This is so accurate.
It's... Fucking it's great.
Godzilla 2.
I love that that picture exists.
Oh,
I
think my God.
It might actually, I think he might have wrote that as a joke, that it's not him.
How do you know?
I can't recall.
Well, or maybe Porsche,
that might be just why
you ever
put it
fucking
lie.
Yeah.
Maybe
come on,
it's, maybe
Elliot.
It's
too you're better than this, Elliot Borge. I don't know.
Borge is the only thing that's wet.
This is a seriously cool picture, though.
I do like this.
It's
I
nice.
Love this.
Sexy, even. Like.
I wouldn't go that far.
Well, you know.
That's
by maybe like the loosest definition ever known to man.
But yeah.
So
sexy.
Yeah,
alright.
Sexy in my balls.
What?
All right. Well, I got one.
All right. So
are we up to the crazies?
I think we're going to show these, and then I think we could do, because we don't have any questions, so do you guys want to do a quick 95 story?
Yeah, sure, we can.
Okay.
Quick dance
party,
and we can
disco dance
verbally
disco dance
describe
party.
How we're dancing.
I'm waving my arms. All right.
I'm doing the Charlie Brown.
So I'm going to... Show you? Should I tell you? Or, I think you guys will figure out what it is.
Maybe
you show
remember.
Show us the first one. And tell us like
remember.
As it's going. Right.
This first one's from Zach M.
Zach M.
Boom.
Johnny Spaghetti Dick here. What's yeah. happening?
Then we got a little baby.
Baby
naked,
size.
Is that naked size?
That,
yeah,
that's a
yeah.
baby. That's a baby,
baby
dick on baby size.
It's on a Dickopedia.
Dickopedia. I'm confused.
I never listened to that episode.
I believe it's all three of us podcasting naked.
Yes,
yeah.
indeed it is.
Oh,
is
that's
that
right.
Right?
Yeah, I'm naked podcasting.
Yeah. The 95th episode, we're supposed to be all naked?
No, no.
Just
they were going to draw the three of us
it was
naked.
Because
there's
a three guys.
Oh,
yeah.
It's so funny.
It was
that's what we
three
did
guys.
When you guys weren't here.
That's pretty great.
Because the first thing we said was like, dicks. And like,
yeah.
Yeah, we just talked about dicks. For a good majority of like better more than 5 minutes.
It was way too many dicks.
Well, this is pretty fantastic, then.
This
right.
is good.
I didn't even notice that Al was naked, because the chair kind of looked like a... Like
that's
a,
my
like
usual
a,
skin color.
Yes. And the chair looked like a jacket or something, like,
okay,
over
yeah.
you, so I didn't think about it, but you
that's,
were correct.
Saito's rocking the halfie, even though he's tiny.
Yeah.
Wait,
oh,
I don't,
look at the little butt,
the
though. Look at the butt.
Well, I've been doing squats.
Yeah.
So.
Yes.
You know what they say. Their anaconda don't want none unless you got bugs.
And they all say that about Sych.
Right.
Yep.
Oh, this
yep.
is
yep.
Oh, this is great.
Thank
thanks, Zach.
Thank you, Zach.
Let's see more nudity.
Next up is from Elliot Borge.
Elliot Borge! I'm kind of scared about this.
Boom.
Oh,
oh no way. Oh, so good.
Oh,
holy shit.
Oh, that's pretty accurate to me, at
oh
least.
Oh, my God.
You do have very fair skin.
Right.
That's... I've what? Seen things now that
dude,
I can't
is that
unsee.
Like your high school yearbook?
That's my high school yearbook photo and his high school yearbook
it's
photo.
The one from Instagram.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
I was about to say, I was like, those look like your high school yearbook photos.
Matt?
That's a damn
yeah,
good
what,
high school
you
yearbook
say?
Photo.
Matt, you'd make a pretty decent chick.
I'd fuck me.
Come on, brought to you by RLF.
Mm-hmm.
I'd fuck me scent.
Oh my God.
Oh,
something feels just so wrong about this picture.
It's so
but great. Then again... It's just that little bit that feels right.
A little bit.
No.
Not one bit.
Area.
Mm. Thanks, Elliot Borge. That was
thanks,
awesome.
Yeah, thanks, Elliot
Thank
Borge.
Thank you, Elliot. And last but not least is from Perch.
Perch?
Perch?
What's
hey,
that,
Perch?
Perch? I don't recall Perch drawn in before.
Perch.
Perch.
A new artiste.
Boom.
Oh, man. That's pretty accurate.
That was so good.
Stop it.
Well done, Perch.
Stop it.
I like how you don't give one shit.
Sych just likes
well,
it from
you.
So reserved.
Sych is the one that's like, I'm uncomfortable.
Yeah.
I'm winking at you, Matt.
I know.
Look at that hat.
Oh, my God.
What's
great.
Happening, hot stuff?
This is fantastic. I love the style of this.
Yeah.
It's so good.
Look at how hairy Matt is.
That's pretty accurate, I mean.
Oh, my God, I love this.
Oh, shit.
I love the little sensor bars.
God.
Oh, well done,
the style
Perk.
Of this is so cool. I love the doodle little background.
Good
the
job.
Doodles.
Good job, Perch.
What's on the table?
The microphone.
It's like, yeah. That is, I guess, the microphone.
Yeah, the microphone.
I thought it was like
condoms. And Al's balls. Yeah.
Bucket of condoms.
We played a party.
I thought it was like, what are those things you put in martinis? Olives? Oh, that was like an olive in a jar for some reason.
Oh, we see Al's happy trail at the beginning of it.
Oh, shit.
I love the detail of the hair. Very cool.
So well done.
This is so fun. Aw, you guys should do more of them naked.
I mean, less is cool too.
No.
Less is more.
Mm-hmm.
No one ever said that.
Every fan art can be us naked now.
I really hope so.
Just doing random things though. Driving a bus.
We told a story. I'm sure we have that where I wrote the erotica of you guys and we went to the cabin. Right?
Oh, yeah. And then you left it on the fridge.
Yeah. Yeah. I got in trouble.
Yeah. It was good.
Have you looked up in the mail? Has anyone written in any erotica of Saich and Nicole yet? Because they got married, so we told people to send in their best, fan fiction of these two. Just
I mean, I could...
Going at it.
Next week. 1996.
Ooh. 1996.
Reverse 69.
I love it. This is so cool, though. Thanks, Perch.
Thank you, Perch.
You are a cool broski,
Perch. Hey, Perch.
Perch.
All right, we got one advice. We got zombies.
Yep.
And of course, I mean, you know, it's episode 1995.
95.
So I think we should do a 95 story at some point.
Okay. When do you guys want to
like
do
right about now?
I want
Sykes
to do the whole 95 story.
Oh, no.
Yes.
All right, so you know the rules. One sentence.
That's never how it turns out, but you have to
That's
do this.
Sykes just a word.
We need
Sykes just a word every time.
Person, place, objective.
You need the five things you need to tell a story are the who, what, when, where, and why.
Right.
Wait, so we have to set it up before we do something?
Yeah.
Well, yeah, we got to set up the basis, and then we got to tell the story.
The who?
Yeah.
Joey Jangles.
Joey Jangles. Who? Nikolai, give me a what.
What?
A roller coaster
like
theme park?
No,
like
what
he's at
he
a
is?
Park.
That's
well,
what
no,
right.
he's, at a, he's at a roller coaster
what?
Theme park.
Yeah.
What's he doing? Is
I could have answered where.
No,
yeah, do have an answer for where. Not,
yeah, do
okay.
Do,
wait,
what,
do
what?
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 I don't know.
I'll do
yeah.
what. I'll do
okay.
What.
Okay. Al will do what then? I'm sorry. So where?
He's at a Blockbuster in 1995.
Blockbuster.
Ooh, Blockbuster.
Oh, wait, that's why we did this one.
Good. We're doing
it. So what
again.
Am I?
Joey Jangles at a Blockbuster in 1995.
We literally
no,
did.
No, we did it.
We did this?
No,
actually,
it was
we
like
did.
The second episode that they did. This is where 95
by
came
by
from.
Themselves.
It's a homage.
It's an
homage. They
homage.
Did it where they go.
Now we're telling the story of Joey Jangles.
Weird thing Blockbuster
was my
idea.
Really?
We did that, yeah.
Yeah, that's what I was. You heard it.
Holland.
No, you heard it before. That's why I'm saying.
No, I want to do Blockbuster.
A year and a half ago, I may have heard
I wanted
it. No, no, I know. I'm just saying that.
Hollywood
my
Video.
1996.
I want to do Blockbuster. Blockbuster? Because I do like
no,
the
no,
96.
No, Reggie just shit all over it, so now I don't want
to. I don't shit all over. I was explaining why you thought of Blockbuster for this reason was because we've obviously talked about it before.
I don't know why you had to shit on it.
Oh, God, fuck it. I'm right, not
so
it. Do whatever you want.
Blockbuster 1995. What's the next question?
Why is he there?
Wouldn't why and what almost be the same thing?
Are why and what the same
oh,
thing?
No, I got... Don't worry.
I don't know how it works. We gotta find out shit.
I'm sorry. Why isn't that easy? Thank you very much. The where is pretty simple.
The who is pretty fucking
all
right, easy, too.
Crabs are attacking.
Crabs
there,
are attacking.
There's a tidal wave of crabs.
And he's taking refuge.
He's taking refuge. I don't know.
It's good.
Thank you. Okay.
So
it's a 95 story. It doesn't have to make sense. I think one time we had a werewolf fuck another thing.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Probably, yeah. It sounds like us.
It doesn't make sense. Okay, so Joey Jangles is at a Blockbuster in 1995.
To hide
and
from
the
tidal wave of crabs.
There's a tidal wave of monster crabs.
What do you have? I have what?
Okay,
what's
your
where,
what?
When?
No, wait, what's
yours? Oh, well, he would have been when, but we got... I'll
think of... Yeah, it
would
have been...
What,
it's fine.
What,
1995
it
works.
It was
what season?
What season? Oh, okay, it's in... December of 1995.
So the water's gonna be real cold.
Oh yeah.
Oh yeah. And what's his name?
Joey Jangles.
Joey Jangles.
He's an unemployed Brooklyn bulldozer driver.
Okay.
That's what he is.
Okay. Oh, yeah. Oh, I like it.
Unemployed.
All right, Joey Jangles, an unemployed Brooklyn. What was it?
Bulldozer.
Bulldozer driver. Bulldozer driver. Takes refuge in a Blockbuster in 1995 to escape an onslaught of crabs.
Title 8, Monster Crabs.
Who's starting?
You, man.
Me?
Yeah, I don't want to start.
It was a cold December morning as Joey Jangles walked down the street.
This day couldn't get any worse. I just got fired.
Hands are the best part.
It's gonna change.
Hey.
Everybody has to do the hands when they're doing a Joey Jangles
like
voice.
Like you're pinching two birds in front of you. Yeah.
All right. What are you?
What are you saying again? I'm sorry.
You just got fired.
This day couldn't get any worse. I just got fired.
It's Arnold Schwarzenegger. All
right.
The only way I can soothe my soul now is to go rent a video.
Dear Lord, I hope they got Pretty Woman in stock.
All right, as Joey is renting his videos, he looks outside and sees a mass group of people running down the streets, leaving their cars and running.
What the hell could this be? He said as he moved to the door to take a gander.
The crabs! The crabs are coming! God, run for your life! I sure hope I don't catch these crabs.
He's already shooting one like this.
He's already shooting one like
this. Oh, Joey.
Joey Jangles. He's a card.
My mother always said I had a good sense of humor.
Is everyone just saying lines of Johnny? Is no one else moving the story along?
I tried to do a line and smooth.
Yeah, I'm like, we're all just talking about it.
It's the accent and hands that gets me.
Alright, so, he opens the door to peer outside, and when he looks to his left, he sees what looks like a giant blue sky with little dots all in it.
Upon closer inspection, he realizes that the wave is not sky is not a sky at all. It's a wave filled with crabs.
Suddenly, Joey feels himself being pelted by small baby crabs as they fall from the sky.
Ow! Who the hell's just throwing crabs at me?
Oh, I better get inside right away before that wave and these crabs land on my head.
Back inside, throws closed the door, and locks it.
Excuse me, sir. What are you doing to my store? Thank you very much.
Listen, you little geek bastard.
I'm angry.
There's a wave of crabs coming, and I'm not be going down today. What?
Oh, goodness. What do you mean crabs are coming?
I mean Joey Jangles doesn't sleep with the shellfishes. Tonight.
Joey Jangles high fives himself for the great pun and then starts pushing the racks of VHSs against the windows.
Well, I'm not going to be in here with some crazy person, the store manager said as he went over and opened the door to step outside.
The 14-year-old store manager.
As soon as the small, young nerd boy stepped outside.
The geek bastard.
Nerd boy!
He was immediately bitten by one of the crabs. And by bitten, I mean clawed at. God bless you.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Ow! Crazy man, help me! They're clawing my flesh off!
Joey Jangles has got your back, super nerd!
He opens the door, grabs the young boy by the collar, drags him in!
Store manager!
Young boy by the collar, brings him inside, and closes the door again.
Oh man, this is just like Jaws. I've seen that a million times. But being a store video owner, video store owner and all.
Now listen, you might know some things about movies, but I am an unemployed bulldozer driver, so listen to me.
We need to get on top of the building. We need to signal for the helicopters to pick us up.
And we gotta do it in a hurry. These walls ain't gonna hold much longer.
I'm pretty positive that the roof is where the crabs are gonna be.
Yeah, but maybe we can get off of the roof in time without, you know, getting squashed by the crab wave. Hey!
I'm the Fonz.
The small nerd boy manager stared, unbelieving, at Joey, unsure of what to do.
Don't just sit there, kid. Get up. We gotta get out of here.
Joey and the small nerd boy manager ascend to the roof, only to be greeted by us. Fuck. Damn it. I don't have anything.
Well, you could pass it to, you could throw it on Reggie. It, yeah. Wild card.
Okay. Yep. So, Johnny and the young store clerk head up. Joey and the young store clerk head up to the roof to see if they can get away from the crab, see if they can signal someone. And up above them, they see helicopters going all over the city.
Oh, we gotta figure out a way to signal those choppers and get them down here.
Just then, a life-size, and by life-size I mean human-size crab, slammed on the roof and started to clip towards the two.
Oh my goodness, what is this thing over here? Kid, go get him.
Kid, go get him. Oh, I don't know what to do with that, mister.
Up above, they see a helicopter coming down a little bit just to hover over them. Johnny yells up, "Help us!"
That's not how Johnny sounds.
Joey. Help us!
You've got to help us.
You've got to help us or something.
There's a giant friggin' crab over there.
Yeah.
The officers open fire, but the bullets, they can't penetrate the crab's hard shell exterior.
Like my mama said, what bullets can't do, my fists can.
Joey charges at the giant crab, fist blazing. Because he didn't have a gun.
Only to be met with reality for one storm. Getting instantly chopped in half.
Oh, Jesus.
And the life-size claw.
Our hero's dead up. I don't know where to go from here. The helicopter above screams out to the young boy clerk, "What the fuck are you doing? Get inside!"
"I got him," Joey Jangle says from the ground as he reaches up and grabs the crab's eye stalks.
Oh my god.
"Let me show you how we do it in Brooklyn."
With the eye stalks in his hand, he starts kneeing him from underneath, cracking the inside. Oh shit, that's right. He starts biting in the eye stalks as he holds on to him.
"Half a torso and I'm still 10 times more mad than you, giant crab."
I mean, that's accurate.
"I'm getting the fuck inside." The young boy clerk leaves Joey to his fate and goes back inside the Blockbuster, where he is safe.
"You can't kill me, crab. I'm already dead inside," he says as he ties the eye stalks together in a knot.
Oh my god.
"Now wait, once your life was, I shall consume it." As Joey starts to squirm inside the crab's mouth.
So Joey becomes the crab and rules over the world forever.
Yeah, it's like the tidal wave didn't even get here.
Oh, I got giant claws now. So.
Hey, I'm a Brooklyn crab.
Oh, fuck bulldozers. I got these.
I'm a burrower now.
Our hero.
And so the Crab King ruled henceforth from that day on night in 1995.
Yeah. Wow, guys.
That was good.
Joe Jangles, the Crab King.
Joey Jangles.
Oh, that's perfect.
That was pretty good, guys.
Getting bad at the Scorpion Gang.
My first feature I'm making.
I love it.
I hit the lottery.
The Ballad of Joey Jangles?
Yes.
Sounds good.
That would probably
be the one that
we've done.
Yes. All right, we got some Invoos Corner.
Voosies.
Invoosies.
Hey, guys.
I'm in the advice corner time. Where you write in and tell them what's on your mind. They have experience and wisdom indeed. They might even give advice you kind of need.
Oh, speaking of hacking real quick before we get into Advice Corner.
Yeah.
If anybody ever wants to feel like an old school like hacker as they portray in the movies, there's a website out there that I found. It's called hackertyper.net.
Okay.
You go on, and it's just a black screen with a blinking green line. And every time you press one key, like seven letters show up. And the more you keep pressing, the faster it looks like you're typing and hacking
like,
into
like
something.
All the,
yeah.
Like in Criminal Minds when Penelope Garcia is just fucking typing. And
oh
like,
my
that's
God.
Not how
you
hack. You
don't
shit.
Understand how fun it is.
Really?
To just. And shit is just flowing up on the screen. If
yeah,
you get
awesome.
A chance.
You do you
should.
Feel like the smartest person in the world? Like, I
you,
got this.
You feel,
Pentagon?
Yeah.
What? What?
Here I go, hack it. And if you hit, like, Alt, I think, three times in a row, it's a. And access granted in big flashing
okay.
green letters.
I'm doing it as soon as I get home. Like, I'm doing it.
I'm hacking in.
Perfect.
Well, my laptop is taking a minute to open Word.
Really?
This is the worst.
Do you have
laptop.
Any more on the hacking thing?
I mean, that's really all you do.
Keep it going, Matt. Keep it going.
Do it again, but say it in Joey's voice.
Joey.
So there's this website where you can go on. And actually, you know, instead of practicing for a real profession like bulldozing,
like a bulldozer,
you can pretend to be one of those natty type hackers from those shitty Matrix movies where you become the one.
And,
oh,
and,
you become the one.
I like the part when Neo is like, I am the one, and then he killed everybody.
That was the best part of the movie.
I like when he goes, "Hey, bullets, stop coming at me!" And he
without
comes,
that
and
scene,
comes.
The movie makes no sense.
No
then
sense
it's just,
at all.
It's just Neo getting his ass kicked.
Are you the one too?
Like a fucking Fagula from you know, one of the Long Island suburbs where they got you know kids and whatnot.
Yeah. With the stuff.
Although it's a very nice life that they have.
Oh,
you know?
Yeah.
It's nice.
It's not like Brooklyn, but it's nice.
No, yeah. You know, you do. I got a nice job. You know, bulldozing. And, I really hope I don't get fired today. I'm gonna go to the the Blockbuster after work.
Go get your keys.
Go get your keys.
Keep going. Keep going.
Really?
No.
I see it up. I'm like, no.
Please don't make me do this anymore.
I quit.
Tommy Gunn, sing us into Advice Corner. Go.
Nice.
Yeah, I know.
I actually forgot. Last week, I mixed it up. I fixed it before I put it out, but I put Advice Corner before fan art.
Oh, really?
Because I keep thinking there's a theme song for fan art,
fan
but
art?
There isn't. And I was like, oh, wait, that's completely wrong.
You should do it just to fuck with people.
Just fuck people. Get confused. All right. All right. We got one from Captain Lunchbox.
Ooh, Captain Lunchbox.
Mr. Captain Lunchbox.
That's Mr. Captain Lunchbox to you.
So perk your ears up and get your focus helmets on, because we got two pages of exposition.
Oh, God. Okay,
I tried to, sometimes he wrote...
Don't say you cut it down, because every time you cut it down, it's crucial
Well, sometimes
parts.
He wrote very, and then I wrote just... One very.
So, guys, about the fan art last week, it turns out his mom didn't die. She's fine. So.
All right. My name is Mr. Captain Lunchbox. I am 16.
What's up, Mr. Captain Lunchbox?
From February to present, I have had the worst few months of my life, and it will only keep getting worse. I was dating a girl for about 5 months, my longest relationship so far. I thought she was really special, so I gave her my virginity. We broke up due to my stupidity. Before I started to date her, I had a crush on another girl, but she started to hate me after some time because of a bad vibe between me and her friend. So he liked the girl, went out with this other girl, but he liked the other girl
Right.
Wait. So he went out with the person that was his girlfriend and went, but he liked this other girl?
Yeah.
Before I started to date her, I had a crush on another girl, but she started to hate me, so I guess.
Oh, okay, gotcha.
Anyway, I bottled up the emotion I had for her and dated the other girl. What ended up happening was that the girl I had a crush on first actually started to love me and thought I was amazing, so I kept talking my entire relationship with my ex. I would be as caring as I could because I am a very caring person when it comes to having friends, but I took it a little too far and my bottled up emotion for her broke free. Around February, my ex couldn't take what was going on because she thought I was cheating on her when I wasn't, so she broke up with me. I felt so very heartbroken, so I blocked the other girl who fell for me first, thinking it would help me get back my ex. It didn't work, and then the time we didn't talk, she stopped liking me, but I was still crazy about her. I kept trying to get close to her again, try to hang out with her so I could surprise her, but by kissing her and showing I cared a lot. Everything I did didn't really work. She still cared about me, but didn't have the strong feelings I had for her. After a time, we just decided to be friends, so I tried to date somebody else. I found somebody and dated them for a month before they broke up with me and said that I wasn't ready for a relationship and they didn't want to be with me if I was a risk of hurting them. I understood and went back to trying for the other girl, but as of a few nights ago, we had a fight and we are no longer friends. All right, so he's trying to date the first girl.
The first girl? Or the girl that he was in a relationship with for 5 months? Because it sounds like he's trying to date the one that he was with a relationship with for 5 months. Hmm. I'm not actually sure.
Date them both, don't tell anybody.
But first, let me point out something. You're with this other girl for 5 months before she breaks up with you. That's the case. And during that 5 months, you were talking to this other girl, and you were being caring, which I'm just assuming was you were being nice to her, and you were talking to her whenever she asked, when it was talking to you. And I'm also assuming that since you bottled up feelings for her, this wasn't completely platonic. Not that you guys said anything or did anything, but it's a thing. It's emotional cheating or whatever you want to call it. You're supposed to be, you know, talking to your girlfriend like that. You're not supposed to be talking to girlfriends like that. That doesn't... You're saying you didn't cheat, but technically it was emotional cheating, and it's a thing that all girls despise and half the time expect, because dudes love to talk to other girls when they're in relationships. Mm. Right, Sage?
I don't know what you're talking about. I never knew something like that.
Right, Matt?
I never talked to another girl.
Yeah. No.
Okay.
That's like, I don't talk to girls.
Girls, yeah. Did I tell you guys the story of the guy who texted me the other night?
No.
Oh, you guys didn't hear the story. Okay. We'll do it later. We'll do the advice corner first.
All right. So continuing from, he said, I understood and went back trying for the other girl, but as of a few nights ago, we had a fight and are no longer friends. The reason behind it is that I smoke weed. I smoke weed because I'm always stressed out, depressed, and can hardly be calm anymore. So I started to do it because it made me feel happy. Her dad, when she was born, was a major druggie and did a ton of drugs. She doesn't like being around people who do drugs. Doesn't matter what it is. I explained to her that I do it because I have no other form of being happy, and it doesn't matter what I do to try and find other ways to be happy. I can't find any. She told me she didn't want to be around people like me and said she would easily push me away if she had to, and that's what she did. In between all of this depressing BS in relationships, I have lost a ton of my friends. The ones I have left treat me differently. I have a few of my friends who are really, really worried about me, and they should be. I've become suicidal and wanted to kill myself more and more every day. I've tried to make new friends, but nobody likes me because they see me as a creep or a weird, stupid fuck. Pretty much, I'm judged like crazy before anyone tries to get to know me. I don't know what to do with myself anymore. My family knows none of what's going on, and I don't want to tell them because I was treated bad as a kid, and I have 5 older brothers and 1 older sister, so they would make fun of me and say I don't know what I'm talking about. Also, my dad seems to hardly care about me because he just yells at me or just won't talk to me. My mom would go around and tell everybody what is wrong with me, and I don't want that to happen. I'm terribly sorry this is so long, but I had to make this message because I'm on the verge of killing myself right now. I wrote up this email and tried to describe it the best I could so everything is understandable and none of you will get lost in this. I hope you all understand it well, and please, for the love of all that is holy fucking, help me and show me at least somebody truly gives a shit about me. Well, we care about you, Mr.
I give a shit.
Dude, we don't give a shit.
Mr. Captain Lunchbox.
Mr. Captain Lunchbox.
I give several shits, even.
Yeah, mm-hmm. Well.
I would go fucking say that.
First off, he said he talked to his parents.
No, he said he didn't want to.
Yeah.
Oh, well, guess what? You kind of got to.
Yeah.
Or a guidance counselor? Could you do that?
You could talk to a guidance counselor, sure.
A guy, but...
Someone at your school.
Yeah.
Someone, but... I'm gonna tell you, they're gonna turn around and
they're gonna tell your parents.
They're gonna tell that to your parents. Yeah. So, and maybe talk with them first before you talk to them, because that's a serious thing, man. Look, shit's hard when you're young. I get it.
High school's the worst.
I was young.
We've all said this.
My first suggestion doesn't sound like you're really happy, and if smoking weed is the only thing that makes you happy, take a break from weed.
Yeah.
You need to be happy without weed before you can be happy with weed.
Mm-hmm. And when it comes to the girl who says she can't really, she doesn't want to be around you if you're smoking weed or whatever, she grew up in a bad situation, and unfortunately she has like a, that's a legitimate thing. I know someone whose father was like a drug addict when they were younger, and they refused to be around any sort of drugs. So that's not against you, that's just to get against that one act that you do, because for her it's too painful to be around. So mm-hmm.
And you can't ask her to change that. That's not her fault.
Yeah, but for your own being, like Matt said, like try finding your way without weed, and by talking to somebody,
it's not healthy to be dependent on it like that. It's not healthy to be dependent on anything like that.
Yeah.
People who are dependent on alcohol like that are called alcoholics.
Yeah.
Heroin addicts. You know, if you're doing one thing that makes you regular, guess what? You're irregular, and you need to fix it.
It's the harsh reality that you have to talk to someone, and you have to get help. But it just, you have to be the one that wants to get help.
Right.
So if you want to get help, if you're reaching out and you want that, then you need to put that effort in. You need to tell your parents, and you need to, and if you don't get understanding from them, then you go and tell your guidance counselor.
Yeah.
And that guidance counselor will do absolutely everything for you. She will find a therapist for you. She will work with you and till you get better. Because you're not alone in this. This happens to a lot of people.
It gets better.
It gets better.
Mm-hmm. As gay as that sounds.
Yeah.
One day you'll have a podcast.
That's right. Yeah, one day you'll have
Start a podcast.
Oh, yeah.
Start a podcast. Mm-hmm.
Show your balls to people.
I feel like Kevin Smith. Call it the Show Your Balls podcast.
Mr. Lunchbox special podcast hour.
Yeah.
It's just you dancing in your room.
What's in my lunchbox? He opens it. There you go. Bologna sandwich.
Bologna sandwich dance break! What's next? Granola bar! Granola bar dance break!
Oh shit, it's a bag of animal crackers! Bag of animal crackers!
Lion!
Oh my gosh.
All right. He's got hashtags for us. This is Matt Doc. So these are all hashtags after. Matt, Doc, this is fucking crazy. Al, shit in my pants. Seich, gay boy. Nikolai, Russian nipples. And yeah. Reggie, bag of truth.
I like that. Dun, dun, dun. Oh my god, Reggie Tater's bag of truth.
Bag of truth.
I did
was that it for our advice?
Oh, that's it for the advice.
Well, I think we have then one more thing to go over.
Oh, indeed we do.
I hope that helped, bro.
I hope that helps.
Seriously, though, let us know how you're doing. Keep emailing us and letting us know how you're doing periodically, because we really do care. We're invested in you.
Indeed.
But I think right now, it's time for...
Zombies?
Zombies?
Huh?
Let's see if we survive.
Oh, brother, zombies!
Well, last week...
I already killed somebody off.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I'm pissed about it.
Who else can I take over and kill?
This week, before we get started, I'm going to need something from the group.
A little drop of
some
blood.
Some information.
Right. I need a number between 1 and 250.
7.
Wow.
All right, do you all agree with 7?
I don't know. Wait, I just said 130. Wait, 137.
One between
177.
1 and 200?
100 a number between 1 and 250.
I think, let's honestly, 125.
No, dude. It's gotta be like 127.
Right on the
fence. Alright, 127.
127.
177?
127.
195?
195. 95?
We need to agree on
95?
I wrote 127, what is it?
I mean, he wrote 127.
Whatever. 127 is fine. Whatever. It should be 95.
The number between 1 and 100.
95.
We'll do 95 there.
Nice.
Between 1 and 50?
Ooh, 42.
Yeah,
42. Ooh.
That's
a good number. Between 1 and 50?
You just said that. Oh,
35.
17? 35? That's too high numbers.
Alright, let's do 24.
Madman.
24.
24.
And another number between 1 and 50.
2.
Ooh.
Okay. We're going with 2, Bob.
Getting low.
Going with 2.
Going with all 2, right. Bob.
We spread. We hedged our bets.
All right.
We're fucked.
So, we're all nuts.
When we last left our heroes, the group has broken out of the town hall that was being swarmed by a horde of zombies. Well, the remainder of the horde of zombies. Matt and Eric, while trying to make a diversion, were climbing into a tree. Eric slipped out, and amongst the commotion created by Reggie and Al escaping from the town hall, Eric fell to his death.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Being eaten alive by these zombies.
Your guy's fault, if anything.
All right. Sorry. I see that.
The first challenge that you guys are going to be facing is, how are we going to get Matt out of the tree? I need you guys to make
Cut
a plan of how you're actually going to get Matt out of the tree. Now, we've got about, I'd say about 20 zombies left. There are a few at the bottom of the tree still finishing the remains of Eric. Matt is distraught and...
He's gonna go ice pick crazy.
All right.
Matt, enough, Matt. Just calm down.
You're crying.
Oh, Jesus.
Always crying.
Always.
You monsters.
Okay, so we have to come up with a way.
Zombies.
Wait, so yes, we have to come. Matt needs to get down from the tree. There's zombies at the base of the tree, still eating Eric. Matt has his ice picks.
Yes, and I believe a weapon.
And a knife, or a gun or something like that.
You have a gun. You still have a
gun with a few
guns. We have guns. Me and Reggie have
guns.
Are we in the town hall?
You have a few guns left. You're outside of the town hall. You're about halfway between the town hall and the tree that Matt and Eric were climbing. And there are about 20 zombies left, but there's only about 10 by the actual tree. The other 10 are scattered about closer to the town hall. And remember, there are people in the town hall who are going to take care of a few of the zombies. The ones, you know, you're not by yourselves.
Can we say, like, it's half? Like, the 10 that are scattered are going to be, like, the town hall people are going to help?
Yes.
Okay. So, essentially, we have 10 at the base of the tree. So, how are we going to get Matt out of there? So, it's technically just me and Al.
Do I see them climbing around?
You see them? I see them.
All right. Are there any thick branches I feel like I could get out from to, like...
All three of you can collaborate.
Okay. I feel like the best way for us to do this would be a drive-by, where you guys clear a path of some of the outsider ones, I climb out onto a thick branch, and then you guys pull up beside the zombies that are around the tree, I fall into the car, and we get the hell out of there.
Do we have a car?
Do you have a car?
I thought you guys had a car.
We do not have a car.
Oh,
we just
shit.
Broke out of the town hall.
Sweet plan.
Shit.
Okay, so what we could do is, if they're all eating and distracted, we could do, like, a close hand-to-hand kind of combat. If there's only 10 of them...
Yeah.
Like, we could realistically go in and bash their heads and try and bash at least, like, 4 or 5 of them between me and Al combined, and then me and you could try and, you know, run off and let him come down, and then we have a meeting place.
Okay.
Good. You know?
So, basically, cause a distraction, then run around,
kill
flank
some
them
of
with
them.
Me.
Yeah, run them around, get them to come after Al and I, and we will go.
I'll come up behind him with the ice picks. Pop, pop!
Just to get you down,
right.
And then
taking
we can try
out.
And find.
Just taking them all out.
Is there a car nearby that we can realistically get to? I don't know if there's any car. Like, could,
there
like,
is,
if we,
but you don't have enough time to get Matt out of the tree.
If we decide to cause a distraction and we're that we kill a couple and then we're running and they're coming after us, and we leave Matt in the tree and we go and the zombies are following us. That's what I'm saying. Like, then he can get down from the tree by himself. Like, we're not helping him. He's figuring it out.
Yeah, technically, yeah. He'd be able
like,
to do that.
Would that be able to work? You got up
the
tree.
But I don't know how to hotwire a car. Do we?
I would be going to hotwire the car while you distracted the zombies.
Wait, he's in the tree, though.
Guys would distract them. I would get down from the tree.
And then he
take out any
over.
Stragglers.
Okay.
And then I would go try and hotwire a car, because I have a feeling I could do that. I was ex-military, right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. So
I'm feeling I could probably do that, and then I come and pick you guys up, probably. I mean, 50-50.
I mean, worst comes to worst, we can make a beeline for the town hall.
Okay.
With the zombies following us. Then at least we'd be back inside the town hall, and there wouldn't be that many zombies left.
If you want to, I'll do the car if you guys want
to do
it. It's up
do
to you.
Do you think the car's a bad idea?
No.
All right. So that's our plan.
Okay, that's our
plan. They're
going
to create a distraction to allow me enough time to get down, kill a couple stragglers, make my way over, hotwire a car, pick them up, take him back to Town Hall.
Alright. Sounds like a pretty solid plan.
The screwdriver breaks.
The way we're going to figure out whether the plan is successful...
Oh, I hope it's not Prize Bingo.
...is with the new game.
Oh, new game.
New
okay.
game.
That, today's theme is something that I absolutely love. And I know that not everybody here is a big fan of.
Oh, God.
Is college football.
Okay.
Oh, God.
Alright, now, it's going to be some college football facts...
No, hold on. There are two people in this room that know college football.
And I barely know it.
Yeah, please, and it's you.
Please,
oh my God.
Let me explain the game.
Multiple choice, I'm sure. We'll be fine.
Please let me explain the game. All right.
Oh my God.
We're going to, the first question I'm going to read, this does not apply towards your answer. This is purely just us playing it one as an example.
Okay.
Just so you can then answer the next question.
Okay.
Which will matter towards your plan for saving Matt's life.
Okay. So example time.
So earlier I had asked you
for
numbers in between certain numbers.
Uh-huh.
I'm going to read you a fact with the number that you told me. All right?
Okay.
I'm going to read you a fact with the number that you told me, and you have to guess whether the actual number involved with this fact is higher or lower than the number you gave me.
Hey, guess what? We should have gone one with every fucking number. Go ahead.
So I was trying to average on every number.
Yeah, but that's the problem.
So, for example, Princeton... I'm sorry. Actually, you know what? I'm sorry. I'm incorrect. I'm going to read a different one.
Okay.
The Sooners' longest win streak was... 24 games between the years of 1954 and 1957. That is the longest win streak in college football history.
I averaged lower.
You're going to say our number's too low, it should be higher?
24 is lower than the actual number.
Oh, okay. So we need...
That's what I'm saying.
So you have to guess.
The actual number is higher.
Yeah, so we have to,
the actual number of the... games.
Yeah.
The actual number is higher. That would be our answer for this.
Yeah.
Okay.
Then your answer would be correct. The actual number is 47.
Wow.
They won 47 games in a row.
I mean, I can do that
Holy shit.
Whatever.
Yes. Right. That's the actual, total
win streak. This game seems all right.
Okay?
All right.
Does that pass the Reggie Taters?
No, you did already, so continue.
You have a choice of higher or... There's a 50% chance you will get it right every time.
Yep.
Or we can call on the nose.
Or you could call on the nose. This one...
This one counts, guys.
Counts.
Get ready. Can Sage help us?
The game... No. Sage cannot help you guys.
Okay.
All right, so it's just us three.
It's a college football game... that had the largest deficit between the victor and the loser was played in 1916 between Georgia Tech and Cumberland College. The total for the game was 127-0, and it ended 15 minutes early. Is the actual number higher or lower?
I would say lower.
You're going to say lower?
I would say lower.
Wait.
I don't think it would be feasible for a team to score more than 127 points.
I mean, the college game that we were doing earlier was 41.
Right, and that was in the third quarter.
That was in the third. Okay. Okay, so lower?
Yeah.
Lower.
You feel the answer? Now, remember, this is to find out if your plan will actually work or not.
Right.
Yeah.
And it will not, because the answer is 222 points.
Who lets a game go on that long?
And it ended 15 minutes early.
Okay, wait, who were the teams?
The teams were in 1916 Virginia Tech versus Cumberland College.
Jesus.
Wait,
did no one from Cumberland College show up to play?
I'm sorry, Georgia Tech. Georgia Tech versus Cumberland College, Georgia Tech.
One.
And it was Cumberland's second or third year as a football.
So the
team was made up. I think there's a rumor that they were like half the marching band was members of the team.
Oh, yeah. That's so sad. I mean, it's more sad that we're probably going to lose Matt.
Georgia Tech won,
Matt.
And then they burned down the other college.
Sure.
Is what they did.
Sure.
Yeah, all right.
So,
as you guys make your drive-by attempt, you make a distraction. You do have a few of the zombies following you. I'd say out of the 10 that were feasting on Eric, 5 begin to follow you. Matt, while he's ascending down the tree, falls out of the tree, landing head first Oh. You don't actually land on your head. You put your hands down, snapping your wrist instantly.
Ah,
okay.
Snapping your wrist instantly.
Left or right wrist?
Left.
Both.
All right, so I'm a righty. I'm all right.
Snapping your left wrist. As you're trying to get up, you quickly stab one zombie through the head with your ice pick. You go for a second one that's coming to your left, right before you, as you're getting up. As soon as you stand up, you've been knocked back down again by the three remaining zombies.
Okay.
Right as they are about to start munching down on your neck, you hear gunshots whizzing past your head, going right through the skulls of the remaining zombies.
Okay.
You look over to the left, and you see standing in the window, Dr. Saichi Boy Talon.
Ooh, Saichi Boy!
Save your mouth!
Coming to save the day.
Watch out.
Better shot than Eric.
Fuck that Eric guy.
For now, yeah.
Ooh, okay. So.
Oh, excellent.
Saichi walks over, helps you stand up. You guys are reunited.
Gross wrist you had.
The town has taken care of the rest of the zombies. As far as the carnage that's been done, I believe one of the soldiers that you guys arrived with is gone. A few of the town members are gone. And now you've got to make the decision between staying in the town and helping rebuild or moving on.
Well,
how is Saich?
Okay.
Good enough.
Sorry, I gotta check my notes here.
Because if Saich is, like, good to go, then I say we book it. But if he needs time to rest,
hey,
then I say
I'm
we
good.
Like, you don't have him.
Saich is in a shape in which that he can travel. Like, his leg was hurt, he's over his fever, the infection has been stopped.
Okay.
I think we've proven that the town is not secure.
This is Herschel's farm, let's get the fuck out of here.
This is Herschel's farm, we need to find our prison, and then fucking leave the prison. So let's go check it out. Wait, is Matt the soldier going to come with us?
No, that's some of the decisions that you guys are going to have to make.
Sure about your little wrist there, buddy.
Yeah, it's not fucking great.
Yeah, we're fucking leaving.
Do you still want to take Matt with you now that he's damaged goods?
No. Hey, you want to come with us, buddy?
Yeah.
All right.
It's his decision. That
I'm not
going to
stay in the town by myself.
It's his decision.
Oh, okay.
There's other people. There's that girl.
Is the town person
with that with the town members. You got to talk to the mayor.
All right. I'm going to do that.
Good.
Are you the mayor
right
now?
Make your speech.
Yeah, I would represent.
Do it.
Yeah.
Hey, it's pretty not fucking safe here anymore.
I mean, I can definitely see why you would feel that it's unsafe, but
right,
we've got a good thing going here.
Do we though?
I mean, with the exception of this one word.
I'm pretty sure. Let's ask Eric.
Oh. I'm dead.
Oh, that's right. Eric died.
All
right,
fine. What's your plan for leaving? Where would we go?
Well, we settle up with this group here, and we travel and find someplace more
They're
secure.
They're strangers, Matt. We've known them for a week.
I'll kiss you.
Yeah.
I'm Saich.
But
I'm
that one saved
truth.
My life. Saich is just standing there waving like a doof.
All right, fine. The mayor agrees, and he says that he'll give your blessing on you guys leaving the town. And if any town member that wants to leave, can leave with you.
Unless they suck. I don't want anybody
Now I need you guys to make a plan for what you're going to try and gather before you actually hit the road.
Fruit and berries.
Berries. Only berries.
Foodstuffs.
The best way to go about this is probably to split up.
Alright.
I don't want to go with Matt.
I'll go alone.
I got bum shit right
well,
here.
Well, you can't put the two cripples with each other.
I'll go with Matt.
Alright, I'll go with Saich.
Great.
Try not to kill you.
I gotta watch my back for zombies and her.
Alright, and who's going after what?
Berries.
We are going after berries.
Strictly berries.
Strictly berries. You guys wish to go out with water or food or fuel.
Or water, meats. Food, fuel, and
get
guns
meats.
And ammo.
Get meats.
Meats.
That's a lot of things to look for.
Well, no, we're not going to get... We have to choose, because we're not getting all those.
Yeah.
Get meats.
Food, water.
You guys are handling food.
Berries.
Berries.
Not just exclusively berries. Handle more than that. We need more things than that. We need, like, guns and fuel.
Oh,
and...
man. I only have two
so
hands.
So we'll search for one thing.
Two hands, one and a half legs.
So you guys will search for berries, and we'll search for...
Berries.
All the other...
Bellies. All right, so I want to bring this down in a second. We're going to be spending our time looking for berries.
Right.
And what?
Meat.
Meat.
Guns. Meat.
Uh-huh.
Fuel.
Yep.
Water.
Okay. No sleeping equipment.
Berries.
Or...
I don't need that.
Oh, no. That's just what us two are searching for. Okay. They're just going for the berries. They don't want sleeping equipment.
All right.
Or,
well... No, we'll get the dead stuff.
Yeah.
We get the good stuff.
You're going to have to answer three questions to see how successful you are.
We're going to be real successful.
While searching for your berries, meat, all the stuff
you need, you know.
All right, no, they're just getting the berries.
Yeah, the rest of you guys.
I keep thinking of Cheeseburger in Paradise. I don't know why.
Cheeseburger in Paradise.
Sorry.
All right,
let's do these questions.
Our next fact, we've got three to answer.
Okay.
In 1905, two men were killed in college football games. Now, is the actual number higher or lower than 2?
Oh, I'm going to say higher.
Yeah.
1905? In 1905, two men were killed in college football.
That was when they didn't wear pads.
Yeah, they wore helmets. I mean...
I'd say higher.
I don't know. I would say higher.
Probably lower, but higher.
Yeah, yeah.
It'd be funny
higher.
If it's like we're all thinking
so
it's lower
two
and
people
it's 38.
Say higher, we have one person says I don't care. We have one person who says lower.
Probably lower, but if more say high, we'll go higher.
And we need an answer from the I don't care.
So two
I didn't say I don't care, I said I don't know.
Two for high, one for low right now.
I mean, I can't say low because then we're split, you know what I mean?
Yeah,
like,
if you think low, then we're going to split and we'll have to talk about it.
We'll flip it.
Higher.
The answer is, in 1905, 18 men
oh, 18.
Were 18 killed.
18 people were killed in a sport.
Yes.
Stop fucking doing it. I don't understand how that's possible.
In the year 1905, it was so bad that President Theodore Roosevelt actually addressed the College Football Board, telling them if they didn't make the sport safer, he was going to shut it down.
Jesus.
There you go.
I'm glad we picked a low number for that one.
Yeah.
That was a good one.
Yeah.
Alright, let's see what
if it said like 15,
I was like,
we would have been like,
we would have been fucked. We
lower.
Lower,
it's got to be lower, right guys?
Alright, I'm a big Notre Dame fan, so this next one is more for me.
Rudy.
Rudy!
Actually, I'm going to say that one for last, because
it's a good one.
Princeton has 42 championships between 1869 and 1950.
Lower.
I would say lower.
Lower. Yeah, lower.
I actually don't know.
They'd have to win like every, just
but,
about.
I mean,
every
they
other.
Were they had a lot of money. They were a big. School.
That's what I'm saying. They were like one of the top
but,
teams.
But
for
how
a long
many
time.
Did we say?
42.
Between 18.
That one's.
I'm saying lower.
Lower.
That was one of the questions that was between 1 and 50.
Yeah.
So our we could have picked 8 higher.
I'm doing lower.
I would say lower.
Okay, let's go. You know, statistics wise, let's go lower.
Lower.
Princeton has 28 championships.
Okay. Nice.
2 out of 3, baby. Let's
Woo!
Go.
We got the berries.
Berries.
We're just getting everything else, though.
Notre Dame has only had 24 losing seasons out of 118 years of football.
Ooh.
Is that number higher or lower?
I think it's higher.
I don't know. Losing seasons as in not like made the playoffs?
Like
losing record.
Losing record
is sub 500.
I'm thinking it's higher, because they were bad for a little bit.
They were? I don't know anything about Notre Dame.
But how little of a bit? How many years
is
that?
I'm saying
118 years.
118 years out of all of them if they had a bad little bit?
Yeah.
I'm saying higher. 24?
So they lost?
24 out of 118. That would mean that 90...
I'm saying higher.
You're saying like they lost 94. More.
I'm saying higher.
Yeah, 94 would be... winning seasons out of 118. That's pretty good.
A lot of winning seasons.
It's a lot. I feel like it would be a bigger deal if that was the actual, if like that was around the number. You know what I mean?
It might be a big deal though. I don't know about college football.
You know anything about college football?
I'm going to say
higher.
You don't
know a ton about college football though.
I mean, higher makes sense.
The actual number is higher than 24.
I feel like the actual number is higher.
Of losing seasons, Seich?
Yeah, higher.
Higher.
Notre Dame has only had 12 losing seasons.
Really?
Out of 118 years.
Wow.
That doesn't count ties, but 12, that's it. Only
hey,
12
two out of three, pretty
seasons.
Good.
I think Nikolai tricked us.
Two out of three is pretty good.
Ooh, whatever, we got the berries. That's
like you got 50
about.
Pounds of berries, no guns.
Nothing else, yeah.
Well, while you guys were out retrieving, you were able to find everything except for the berries.
Are you fucking kidding me?
Turns out not berry season.
Oh.
Not berry
season. It's always berry season.
No, actually, you did a good job of finding water. You were able to find some canned food. And you do have ammunition and some sleeping material. You'll have enough to drive. No one said car, so you don't have a means of transportation.
Well, that's soon.
There was a car right there, so I figured that we were just going to
I never said there was a car right there.
You did! When we were going to get if there was a car in the
Yeah, weren't they going to hotwire a car?
I said that there were cars. I didn't say it was right there.
Alright, well,
I said if it was in distance,
you'd have to get a car. Right, anyway,
I'll ask the mayor for one.
As you guys return back,
everyone's dead.
As you guys are retrieving back to the town hall with the supplies you've gathered for the trip, you hear the mayor scream out from around the corner.
Oh, man! I hope that's not the signal of the town being fucking unsafe.
You run around the corner to see that the mayor has been bitten in the arm.
In
the forearm. As he sat down on a bench, a zombie that was still alive jumped up and bit his forearm. He ripped himself away from the zombie, but now he's running towards you guys, showing that he's been bit.
Shoot him in the head.
Are you going to take his arm off and try to save his life, or are you going to shoot him in the head?
Matt goes, we're taking a fucking car, and just pops him.
I asked the mayor, what do you want? What do you want to do?
You can't ask him, you just gotta ask.
Save my fucking life, man.
Chop it off.
Take his arm.
Cut it off, we're cutting it off. Cheeseburger in paradise.
And we're gonna find out next week.
Oh.
If taking his arm off.
Hopefully he dies.
Save the mayor.
Mr. Mayor!
I'll let you know, if he doesn't survive, you will not have the favor of the town anymore.
Fine, we'll leave. I'm glad you didn't use a gun.
Well, guns are dangerous.
They're pretty
unsafe. Well, yeah, because you can't take an arm off with a gun.
Really?
Exactly.
Well, I mean, not easily.
Well, I mean...
I don't know.
Depends what kind of gun.
Look, this town's not safe to me anymore. I would need to at least carry a gun if I was going to be there.
A couple guns.
And you know what they say.
What do they say about guns?
That if I need a gun,
yeah,
Taters, yeah. I
am probably in a situation.
Hell don't want to be there.
Mm-hmm.